ॐ सहनाववतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्याम् मा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरते यौपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादम् शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तमेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐमित्येतदक्षरमुद्गीतमुपासीत ॐमिति ह्युद्गायते तस्योपव्याख्यानम् Then continuing, said Sanat Kumara said that Sankalpaha, which normally means will, but here it is Kartavya Kartavya Vishaya Bhagena Samarthanam. The determination that takes place in the mind, when the mind Vibhaga is able to distinguish between Kartavya and the Kartavya. Meaning, before doing anything in the mind, this process takes place, which there is determination of whether this thing is proper to do or not. Kartavya and Kartavya. Is it proper to do? Should I want to do or not? That determination first takes place, then actually the action takes place. So, that is called Sankalpa. Sankalpa va manaso bhuyan. This is better than, superior to, sarla than, manasaha means manasyanam, chikirsha buddhihi. What is manasya or manasyanam? Chikirsha buddhihi. The intention to do something. So, first, the determination of what is to be done. Secondly, then, the intention to do that. That's called manasyanam. So, sankalpa is better than manasyanam, manas. यदा वै संकल्पयते कर्तव्याद विषयां विभजते इदं कर्तुं युक्तमिति. फर्स्ट इन द माइंड व्हेन संकल्प टेक्स प्लेस व्हेन विभजते ही डिवाइड्स कर्तव्याद विषया व्हाट इज टू बी डन व्हाट इज नॉट टू बी डन दैट विभाग इज डन देन इदं कर्तुं युक्तम. सो दिस पर्टिकुलर समर्थनम और डिटर्मिनेशन इदं कर्तुं युक्तम इट इज प्रॉपर टू डू दिस दिस कॉल्ड संकल्प. अथ मनस्यति देन देयर इज चिकित्सा बुद्धि देन देयर इज इंटेंशन टू डू दैट. फॉर एग्जांपल मंत्रान अधीयेय इत्यादि मे आई रिसाइट द मंत्र. सो फर्स्ट द डिटर्मिनेशन टेक्स प्लेस दैट इट इज प्रॉपर इदं कर्तुं युक्तम इट इज प्रॉपर टू रिसाइट द मंत्र. Then comes the desire, may I recite the mantra intention. Atha anantaram vacham irayati. So when then takes place in the mind, the desire to recite the mantras, vacham irayati, that desire impels the organ of speech to utter. Mantra adi uccharane. Speech is impelled. Not to utter anything, mantra, uccharane, for utterance of mantra, etc. Tam chavacham, u namni. So, irayate. But before a mantra is chanted, mantra is a word, this particular word is called mantra. Before that, a word is to be uttered. So, a desire to utter words in general. सो नाम इरयति नामोच्चारण निमित्तं विवक्षां कृत्वा इरयति दैट मे आई नाउ अदर यू कैन क्रिएट एनी साउंड ऑफ कोर्स इन द ऑर्गन ऑफ स्पीच बट नामोच्चारण यदि उच्चारण और अटरेंस ऑफ द नाम नेम अविच मंत्र इज अ पर्टिकुलर वर्ड. सो मंत्र शब्द विशेषाः यू कैन डू विसलिंग ऑल्सो विद ऑर्गन ऑफ स्पीचिंग इन टू एनीथिंग. But here, namocharana. So may I utter the words and then further the words are impelled to utter the mantras. Because nama samanya mantra shabda vishesha. What is mantra? It's only words only. But particular kind of words are called mantra. So first, the desire to utter words in general. Then that desire gets transformed into utterance of words in particular. We are called mantra. So this is namni mantra ekam bhavanti. The mantra which are particular words, they become included into nama which are the words in general. मंत्रेषु कर्माणि सो सामान्यैः विशेषः अंतर्भवति द पर्टिकुलर गेट्स इंक्लूडेड इन द जनरल द रूल. मंत्रेषु कर्माणि एकं भवन्ति अगेन ऑल द कर्मास ऑल द रिचुअल्स आल्सो गेट इंक्लूडेड इन मंत्र मीनिंग दैट दैट डिजायर टू अटर मंत्र अल्टीमेटली गेट्स कन्वर्टेड इनटू डिजायर टू परफॉर्म ए पर्टिकुलर रिचुअल. So how do you say that all the rituals get included in mantras? Mantra prakashatani karmani kriyante na amantrakam asti karma. So reiterating here, the conclusion arrived at in the Purva Mimamsa. Bhashyakara says, mantra prakashatani karmani kriyante. Whatever rituals are performed, they are all performed which are revealed in the mantras. So rituals, of course, are all described in Brahmana section of the Veda. But Brahmana only is an elaboration of the mantra. So Vashyakara says, based on the Purva Mimamsa, that all the rituals have their basis in mantra. They are basically revealed by mantras. So, na amantram karma asti and amantrakam asti karma. that cannot be a karma or ritual which does not have its origin in mantra. There is a siddhanta. Yaddi mantra prakashanena labdha sattagam sat karma. Then only when the mantra reveals the karma of the ritual, then the brahmana elaborates on the ritual. How does it elaborate? So idam kartavyam asmi phalayati vidhiyate. Then brahmana section says idam kartavyam, this ritual must be performed asmi phalaya, for this particular result. So that's what brahmanas do. Meaning the brahmana section does not enjoin an original ritual. The origin of all the rituals is to be found in mantra section, not in the brahmana section. If you do not find some relevant mantra, then you infer or presume that a mantra must be there somewhere. Yavi upattihi brahmaneshu karmanam dushyate. In case you do not find the original mantra, or you find that, or upatti, whatever origination you find in the, of the rituals in Brahmana, sapi mantreshu labdha sattakanam eva karmanam spashti karanam. The Brahmana only clarifies what has all been revealed by the mantras. So this is basically Siddhanta arrived at in the Purva Mimamsa. Bhashyakara only reiterates that Siddhanta. Nahi mantra aprakashitam. Karma kinje brahmane utpannam drishyate. You do not find in Brahmana section any ritual that has not been originated from the mantra. But sometimes you find that the ritual in one branch of Veda, the three Vedas, Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sam Veda. So sometimes says, Ekasyam Shakhayam Yat Karma Mantreshu Anupalabdham the Shakhantariya Mantra Prakasharam Bhavishyadevi. So all the three Vedas, Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sam Veda, all of them are taken as one body of mantra. And therefore, it is possible that the ritual found in Yajur Veda may have its origin in the mantra of the Rig Veda, etc. But that's all considered as one body of knowledge. So, trai vihitam karma iti prasiddham loke. People also know that the karma of the ritual is enjoined by the three Vedas. Trai karma vihitam. Trai shabdasya rug yajus samakhya. Word trai means the rug, yajus and samveda. Also, so it is prasiddhi. What is prasiddhi? Trai vihitam karma iti prasiddham loke is known in the world or with the people who are in knowledge that the karma is or rituals are revealed by the three Vedas. Mantreshu karmani kavayo yanya pashyami vija atharvane. Mundagopi has also said mantreshu karmani kavayo yanya pashyam tani tretayam etc. So the karmas are seen by the sages in the mantra. The idea is that originally karma, a ritual is seen in the mantra by the sages, and the brahmana then elaborates upon that. Tasmad yuktam mantreshu karmane ekam bhavandeti. Therefore, it is quite proper that all the rituals get included in the mantra. Tani hava etani sankalpikayanani sankalpatmakani sankalpe pratishthitani. Tathavi katham sankalp se bhuyastham. All right. Suppose this is what it is. Sankalp is the cause of everything after ritual. Sankalp is the cause for the manasyam. There is a chikirsha, the intention to do something that causes the speech to utter. Utter the mantras, which include all the rituals. So beginning from manas, all the way up to the karma, the ritual, all of these, tani havayetani, sankalpa ekayanani. So sankalpa is greatest. Sankalpa vava manaso bhuyan. How is sankalpa greater than manas? Because everything being from manas, all the way up to karma, tani havayetani, sankalpa ekayanani. Sankalpah ekah ayanam gamanam praya yeshantani sankalpah ikayanani. Sankalpah is one ayanam. Ayanam is a goal or destination or the place of merger. Meaning that all of these merge into sankalpa at the time of dissolution. Sankalpahatmakani utpattav. They are always identified with sankalpa. So during their existence, during the creation and existence, so during their creation also, they emerge from sankalpa. Sankalpe pratishthitane. I mean, sankalpa is there all along. Sankalpa is there before the creation of manas and etc. Because only when sankalpa takes place, avidam kartavyam, then only the desire, intention to do takes place. Meaning that manas originates from sankalpa. Manas is just being in sankalpa. The sankalpa flows through and through, you know, in the desire to do and then what is done. And ultimately when everything is complete, all rituals are complete, everything is complete, then it merges back into sankalpa also. So that way, sankalpa na kevalam, sankalpasya karanatva matram. Not only sankalpa is nimitta, the efficient cause for propelling all the steps up to the ritual, apidu upadhanatvam api, but sankalpa also is upadhana of all of them. All of them have their origination in sankalpa, they are sustained in sankalpa, they merge back into sankalpa. अतः मनसोपि आंतरं सूक्ष्मरूपं प्रत्येगात्मनः सन्निहितं संकल्पः इति. Therefore, sankalpa is superior to, subtler than manas. What is subtler? Closer to the pratyegatma. Pratyegatma, the indwelling self, is the subtler than the subtlest. Subtlest a thing is superior it is to the grosser. इतस्य संकल्पस्य अस्ति महत्वम् संकल्पस्य उपासत्वाय स्तुतिम् आह उपनिषद. Because संकल्प is meditated upon, then उपनिषद, then the teacher says, so संकल्पम् उपास्वयते. You meditate upon संकल्प. For meditating on something, it must be worth meditating upon. It must be something which is exalted, something which is worthy, something which is adorable, something that is worshipful. Therefore, stuti maha. The stuti or the praise or extolling of sankalpa is stated. Says, samaklupatam dyava prithivi. Heaven and earth, they willed. So you can see the will flowing through and through the whole creation. In all the five elements, we find the will being very much present. Because each of the five elements conducts itself in a particular manner. It never swerves from its nature. Earth does not swerve from its nature of being firm and sustaining everything. The heaven does not swerve from its nature of illumining everything. And then water does not swerve from its nature, fire does not swerve from its nature, air, they are all predictable. meaning that they simply willed to be so and so, and that is why they are what they are. Yatha kaschid loge purusha yat kinje sankalpya tato na chalati. So in our day-to-day life also, when you find that a person is committed to something, he is unswerving in something, that means that he has resolved. That these are the 9 days of Navaratri, no salt for this. So we find the person is sticking to that. That sankalpa is through, flowing through and through. Because normally you eat salt and many other things, and several times a day. But these days only one time a day, no salt. Except when you do that, that shows that the sankalpa is what will bring about a consistent behavior. When a person does not swerve from its conduct, then we know that some sankalpa or the will must be there. Swarth does not swerve from its behavior, from its nature, from its dharma, of being firm and sustaining everything. That shows that the sankalpa is there in pursuing in the heaven. Samakalpetam, vayuscha, akashamcha. Similarly, vayu and akasha also, they also willed, because they also nischare lakshyate. We find that also nischal, unserving from their nature. Samakalpantam apascha tejascha. Then water and fire also, they also willed. So the question was, these five elements are inert, how can they will? So upachariyate, yava prasivyabhi charana abhava guna yoga. Just as in day-to-day life, a person does not swerve from his conduct because he is willed to be so and so, we find that these five elements also do not swerve from their nature. Therefore, we say in a secondary sense that they have willed. Or you can say that Ishvaryava Sankruptayate, or Ishvara has willed them to be so. So Ishvara Sankalpa flows through and through, that also you can say. So then Samaklupata, all of them will change to Sankrupte, etc. Meaning that, so Karmasattvam Kriyapadasya Drashtavyam, so Samaklupata, all must be changed to Karma. Meaning the elements did not will. Ishvara willed them to be so. So they are the objects of willing, not the agent of willing. That would be the Chandasi Prakriya. Ishvara Nishthasan Sankalpa Dhyava Prasavyalevi Sarvasya Janakahiti Stutihi. So therefore, in Ishvara Sankalpa, that is the creator of everything, either way. So as each individual one sankalpa flows through and through, or Ishvara Sankalpa flows through and through, either way. Then shows how sankalpa then flows, continues. Tesham sankalpte varsham sankalpate. Since the five elements have willed to conduct themselves in a particular manner, therefore the rain is there. The rain could not be with the five elements, did not conduct themselves the way they do. So sankalpa, the will, obtaining the five elements then, flows through in the rain, which makes the rain what it is. And so, varsham sankalpade samarthi bhavade. The rain is able to do what it does because of the sankalpa, which again comes from the sankalpa of the five elements. Varsha sankalpte annam sankalpate, because the rain wills to be what it is, therefore the food also is what it is. That food is able to appease the hunger of the creatures, that consistently the food displays that behavior. That shows the food also has will. And why the food, why annam, has this effectiveness or capability? That is because the rain will be so and so, therefore the annam or the food also is so and so. Annasya sankalpate pranaha sankalpante. When the food is there, then the prana, the vital air also, they are effective in doing what they are. So it is annam dhamayate shruti. So Brihadaranyakopanishad said that annam, the food is like dhamma, like a rope. So just as you tie, let's say, calf to a post. So how the rope connects the post with the calf. So calf doesn't escape. So also food ties the prana with his body. So prana does not escape. That means that the prana are dependent upon food. Tesham sankalpate mantraha sankalpante. So when the prana behave, conduct themselves the way they do, then alone it is possible to recite the mantras. Pranavani mantra adhite. One who possesses that vital air or vital force alone can recite the mantras, not a weak person. Mantranam sankalpyai sukkarmani sankalpante. Sankalpa which flows through in the mantras then flows into the karma, the rituals. Meaning that then the rituals are able to produce the result. What is a ritual? A ritual is that which produces a particular result. That is sankalpa the ritual. A sankalpa ritual manifests as producing a specific result. How did the ritual get the sankalpa? From the mantra. So mantra prakashikani, agnihotradi, anushthiyamanani, phalaya samarthi bhavanti. They produce the result. Karmanam sankalpate lokah sankalpate. So sankalpa the karma to produce a result. So lokah sankalpate. Then the result is connected to a particular karta. So not only does the karma produce a result, but the result also gets attached to the karta, or the person who performed the ritual. So slokah phalam sankalpate karma kartru samvayataya samarthi bhavati. So the outcome, the result of this ritual gets only connected to the agent who performed the ritual. So that is the will showing in the karma phala. Lokasya sankalpyai sarvam sankalpate. So then when karmaphala, so what does karmaphala do? Sarvam jagat sankalpate sarup avaikalyaya. It produces the entire jagat, and jagat also conducts itself in a very specific way. So this everything in the creation also has its nature, which is immutable, which is because of the result of the karma phala. So sankalpa the karma phala makes a jagat what it is. Etaddhi idam saram jagat yat phalavasanam tat saram sankalpa moolam. So the entire creation that we see, in which all the different names and forms of elements, they conduct themselves in the way they do, is because of the sankalpa. The entire creation has its moolam, the root in sankalpa. That's how sankalpa is praised here. Atah vishishtah saisha sankalpah. He says, Narada, sankalpa, the will is vishishtah. He is exalted in this manner because the entire creation has its root or source in sankalpa. Ata sankalpa upasva. Therefore, may we meditate upon sankalpa. Idi uktva phalam aha tad upasakasya. We enjoin, we meditate upon sankalpa, then you should tell also what is the benefit of that meditation. So we are on the page 308. We read that mantra, we read the mantra, the passage number 3. Seha sankalpam brahma ityupaste. Kluptan vaisalokan. Dhruvan, Dhruvah, Pratishthitan, Pratishthitah, Avyathamanan, Avyathamanah, Avisiddhyati, Yavas Sankalpasya Gatam, Tatrasyatha Kamacharo Bhavati, Yes, Sankalpam Brahmetyupaste. Asti Bhagavas Sankalpad Bhuya Ide. Sankalpad Bhava Bhuyo Stide. Tanme Bhagavan Bravitvite. So, Sankalpam Brahmetyupaste. One who meditates upon the sankalpa as Brahma. So therefore, so whatever the sankalpa did, that's what he gets. Sankalpa has created the whole universe, understand? Therefore, the one who meditates upon sankalpa also attains all those worlds. So kliptan vase lokan dhruvan dhruva 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 san dhruvan lokan Avisiddhyati, himself becoming dhruva, becoming immutable. He attains immutable worlds, himself becoming immutable. What kluptan lokan? The worlds that are so willed. So bhuhu, bhuvaha, swaha, mahaha, these are the worlds. They are willed by Ishvara to be so and so. And this person who meditates upon the sankalpa as Brahma, attains those worlds, himself becomes dhruva, becomes immutable, attains the immutable worlds. Pratishthitaha, pratishthitan, lokan, abhisiddhyati. He himself becomes then established, self-established, attains the worlds that are also established. Avyasamanan abhisiddhyati. Becoming sorrowless, yet in worlds that are also sorrowless. So this is the result of this meditation upon sankalpa. He himself gets transformed. Then only he can attain or enjoy those worlds. Yavas sankalpasya gatam tatrasya yatha kamacharo bhavati. So whatever be the range of sankalpa, he gets the freedom of movement in that whole region, which is the range of sankalpa. Yes, sankalpam brahmetyupaste, one who meditates upon sankalpa as Brahma. Asti bhagavah sankalpat bhuyahaiti. O venerable sir, is there something superior to sankalpa? Sankalpadvava bhuya asti iti. Yes, my dear, there indeed is something superior to sankalpa. Tanme Bhagavan bravitviti. May the venerable sir tell me what that which is superior to sankalpa. So going to the Bhashya, in the 7th line. Sayah sankalpam brahma iti brahma buddhya upaste. So sayah sankalpam brahma. Sankalpa is brahma, means what? Brahma buddhya. Superimposing the idea of brahma upon sankalpa, looking upon sankalpa as brahma. Having Brahma Bhavana upon Sankalpa. So says the Tikakara Abhinava Narayana Manindra in the 928. So Brahma Drishtya, Brahma Buddhya Upasa, Brahma Drishtya Upasa, whatever. So Brahma Buddhya Upasa, one who meditates upon Sankalpa as though it is Brahma, or Brahma Drishtya Upasa, one who looks upon Sankalpa as Brahma, as Bhavana, that Sankalpa is Brahma. So Tikakara says, इति शब्द शिरस्कत्वेन ब्रह्म शब्दस्य साक्षात् संकल्प ब्रह्म शब्दयो सामान्यकरण्य अभावात् इति शब्द सामान्यकरण्य सति तदर्थ ब्रह्म प्रकारकत्वं संकल्पस्य सिद्ध्यते. दिस डिस्कशन केम अर्लियर आल्सो. द संकल्प सो देयरफॉर संकल्पं ब्रह्म इति उपास्यते. So, that Sankalpa is Brahma. It's not actually Brahma, but is Brahma. Meaning that one who superimposes the idea of Brahma upon Sankalpa. Sakshat Sankalpa Brahma Shabdayo Samadhikarani Abhavat. Because the Iti Shabda comes therefore, the Asamadhikarani is between what? Iti Shabda Samadhikarani Sati. Iti upaste, that's all. So samadhikaran is not between sankalpa and brahma. Sankalpa is not brahma, iti upaste. So iti samashanga samadhikaran. Therefore, the way upaste, he meditates in that manner. Therefore, tadartha brahma prakarakatvam sankalpasya siddhyati. Sankalpa is like brahma. Sankalpa is like Brahma because Brahma also is all pervasive, Sankalpa also is all pervasive, and that when, in that sense, Sankalpa possesses a similarity with Brahma. Therefore, based on that similarity, you can look upon Sankalpa as Brahma, a Brahma Drishti or Brahma Buddhi. That's such a Brahma Prakara, Brahma Drishti Vishatvameva, Anyas Asambhavat. तद्दृष्ट्या उपासनम सिद्ध्यति इत्यर्थः. सो ब्रह्म प्रकार इज लाइक ब्रह्म. संकल्प इज लाइक ब्रह्म. संकल्प इज लुक्ड अपॉन एज ब्रह्म. लाइक प्रणव लुक्ड अपॉन एज ब्रह्म. लाइक एनी मंत्र लाइक एनी विग्रह लुक्ड अपॉन एज ईश्वर. सो ऑल्सो संकल्प इज लुक्ड अपॉन एज ब्रह्म. So that is how the meditation takes place upon Brahma with the help of Sankalpa. So meditation is on Sankalpa. Rather, is not on Brahma but on Sankalpa. That Sankalpa is Brahma. So meditates upon Sankalpa. That's the whole idea here. Iti Shabda says that meditation is not on Brahma. Meditation is on Sankalpa. But then where does Brahma come in? That Sankalpa is Brahma. So meditation takes place upon this Vigraha as Lord Krishna. So either you can transcend the Murti and meditate upon Lord Krishna, or you can meditate upon the Murti itself, form itself as Lord Krishna. So also meditate upon Sankalpa itself as Brahma. Therefore, you become identified with Sankalpa. And therefore, you have the freedom of movement wherever the range of Sankalpa is, you see. Then Mahashyakara says, Kluptan Vighatra. अस्य इमे लोका फलमिति कृतान् समर्थितान् संकल्पितान् सविद्वान् ध्रुवान् नित्यान् अत्यंत अध्रुव अपेक्षया ध्रुवश्च स्वयं लोकिनो हि अध्रुवत्वे loke dhruvaklaptihi vyartha iti dhruvasan. So kluptan loka, he attains those worlds which are kluptan sankalpitan tatra by Ishvara. That is why the Tikakara included that reading, that it is Ishvara Sankalpa, Ishvaraneva Sankalpa iti. Because this passage says kluptan vai. So kluptan means, suppose Bhashyakara dhatra kluptan. Otherwise all the worlds that are there, the bhuhu, bhuvaha, suvaha, mahaha, is all part of jagat. And jagat is what it is because of the sankalpa. So karma phala had the sankalpa that jagat should be like this. So sankalpa of the loka or the karma phala is evident in the jagat. So that means the klupta, means all the worlds are in fact sankalpitan, samarthitan. But kluptan, it is said, therefore, it is not the worlds that do the sankalpa, they are the product of somebody's sankalpa. Therefore, dhatra kluptan, the worlds are what they are because they are so willed by Ishvara. How? Asya me loka phalamete. So Ishvara then does the sankalpa that may this upasaka get this lokas. That's how he gets those worlds. Iti kluptan will, samarthitan, sankalpitan iti. So samarthitan, so determined, sankalpitan, so willed. Say the tika, sankalpitan iti, sankalpa matrena, samarthitan, sampaditan ityartha. All that is required is sankalpa or the will on the part of Ishvara, because of which the worlds are what they are. So they are determined just by the will, and that's how they are accomplished. Meaning that the worlds are what they are simply because of the will of Ishvara. Meaning nothing more than that is required for the creation of what it is. So Ishvara's will then flows through and through and through and through to become this universe, including all the different worlds. So you can say that Ishvara has willed them to be so. Sahavidvan, Dhruvan, Avisiddhyati. Avisiddhyati means attains. So Dhruvan Lokan Avisiddhyati. He attains the immutable worlds. Swayam Dhruvasan, himself becomes immutable, he attains the worlds that are also immutable. So Ananagiri says, Atma Atiriktanam Lokanam Katham Nityatvam. Atma is Nitya. However these worlds are up to Brahma Loka, Atma Atiriktanam, they are different from Atma. So Katham Nityatvam, how can they be Nitya or eternal? So Bhashyakara said, Atyanta Adhruva Apekshaya Dhruvam. So these worlds are immutable, eternal in a secondary sense. Compared to the world that we are familiar with, which are extremely mutable, as compared to that, he attains worlds that are immutable. That's what this Tikakar also said. Upasana janyasya phalasya atyanyatyat anupatte apekshikam. Upasana is a karma, is mental action. And karma produces results. But karma being mutable, the result also will be mutable. Atyanyatyat anupatte apekshikam nityatvam. Therefore, he attains worlds that are, in a secondary sense, immutable. Then say Nanagiri, Lokanam evam dhruvatvam uchyata. All right? It's all right to say that the lokas or worlds are immutable in this manner. In a secondary sense. Kividi lokyaha tad uchyate dhruvasan. How come the fellow lokina, the one who is in the loka, how can he be immutable? So Vashyagara said, why should he be immutable? Lokinohi adhruvatve loke dhvaklukti vyathasya. What's the point in having immutable world when the fellow who enjoys the world is mutable? So what's the point in having lots of wealth when you are not there to enjoy it? Therefore, just as the worlds that are enjoyed are immutable, this upasaka also becomes immutable. So dhruvasan abhisindyati he attains. Then Vashya explains, pratishthitan, pratishthita means pratishthitasan, pratishthitan lokan abhisindyati. Himself becomes well established, attains worlds that are also well established. Vashyagara says, pratishthitan upakarna sampannan ityarthah pashuputradibhi pratitishthate iti darshanat svayam cha pratishthitah atmiya upakarna sampannah. So pratishthitan, what is pratishthitan? Well established. What is well established? Upakarna sampanna, possessed of the accessory upakarna. So the worlds that are possessed of the accessories of enjoyment, he attains all those worlds that are immutable and possessed of also the accessories of pleasure or enjoyment. So see, Nandini katham upakarana sampanneshu pratishthi shabdo bhavadeti. He enjoys the world that are very well provided by the accessories of enjoyment. So how do you call the pratishthita well established? So Vashyakara says, pashuputradivihi pratitishthate iti darshana. So this is what we see. That one becomes well established when one is provided with a lot of wealth in terms of pashu, putra, etc. Then a person is well established. That's the other Tikaka also said, pratishtha shabdasya katam upakarana sampatti vachyatvam tasya sthiti vasavidashankya siddham prayogam darshayati. So pratishthita is, so how do you, it is sthiti vachitva, is well established. How do you say that it says upakarana sampatti? That pratishtha means the sampatti or the wealth in the form of the means of enjoyment. How do you say that? Siddham prayogam darshayati. This is what people say. Well, no. What is it? Pashuputradivihi pratitishthati darshanat. We find that people say that a person is well established when he has all his wealth of pashu, putra, etc. Pashvadi upakaradi pratitishthati prayoga dushta ityata. So, this is, sometimes you take the yogika artha, sometimes you take a rudhi artha. So, different artha depending on where it fits. So, rudhi artha. So, pashvadi upakaradi, the person who is possessed of the accessories of enjoyment such as the cattle, etc., is called well established. Therefore, the worlds which possess this are well established. Nimbashakara says, Swayamcha pratishthita atmiya upakarana sampanna. So, worlds possess all of that. He also possesses them. Atmiya, so upakarana sampanna. He also possesses the capacity to enjoy those things. So the worlds or realms in which he is, they are possessed of all the objects of enjoyment and he is pratishthita. He is well established in what? He also possesses the capability of enjoying those things. Tani cha bhoga sadhanani sharendriya shrirendriya dini tat sampanna. So you must have a healthy body, healthy sense organs, a mind, you know, then you can enjoy those things. So the worlds which he enjoys are possessed of the means of enjoyment, such as Pashuputra. He himself also is possessed of the capacity of enjoyment himself, the firm body, sense organs, etc. So avikala indriyadiman is having a firm sense organs. So ability to listen, ability to see, ability to think, ability to, you know, enjoy in the mind, aesthetic sense, everything he possesses. You have the whole world before us. But whether we can enjoy that world is a different matter. The beautiful flowers are there, butterflies are there, and then so the honeybees are there, so many things are there. Just like keep on taking around with making no note of anything. So enjoy what is also requires a great capacity. So they were pratishthitah san, being well established in himself with the capability of enjoying those things, he enjoys a world that are also well established. So lokanam upakarana sampattistu bhogya srakshindanadi sampatti iti bhedah. So both sampattis are there. The world's possess sampatti in terms of bhogya padartha, the objects of enjoyment. He possesses sampatti in terms of the capability of enjoyment. So that sampatti means different in the two cases. Then Bhashyakara just further. Avyasamanan amitraditrasarahitan avyasamanascha svayam abhisidhyate abhipraapnote ityarthah. Avyasamanascha svayam. Then an important thing is himself becoming sorrowless. Otherwise again you can't enjoy things. Even when you have capability of enjoying, if you are sorrowful in your mind, then food also does not interest, nothing interests you. Therefore, not only possesses the firm sense organs in the body, also possesses a cheerful mind. So, avyasamana. So, upasana does all of this. Upasana gives you a cheerful mind, gives you a firm body and sense organs, gives you also the objects of enjoyment. And how long? Immutable. You become immutable, they are also immutable. So, avyasamana, those worlds are free from shoka, from sorrow. So you must be in a place which is free from sorrow also. So Vasya, what causes sorrow? Amitra aditra sarahita. Amitra. Your mitra gives you happiness. Amitra gives you misery. So one who is enemy, who you look upon as amitra, that very sight, that very presence of that person also makes you sad or sorrowful. So the world may be there, wonderful. But then there are people, you see them, you know, and then you just feel miserable. So everything is provided to you. You are provided the capacity also. And still, the place in which you live has all these amitra, all these non-friends or enemies. Then you become sorrowful. So no, he also is cheerful. And enjoy the world that are also free from. So amitrasa means fear. So amitradi trasa rahitan avyasamanita swayam. Being cheerful, also enjoy the world that are free from any sources of sorrow. Abhisiddhyati Abhiprapnati. He attains those worlds. Then Bhashyakara says further, Yavat Sankalpasya Gatam Sankalpa Gocharah Tatra Asya Yatha Kamacharo Bhavati Atmanah Sankalpasya Natu Sarvesham Sankalpasya Iti. So Yavat Sankalpasya Gatam. So whatever is the reach of the Sankalpa, as far as the range of Sankalpa is, Tatrasya Yatha Kamacharo Bhavati. He has the freedom of movement. Like says Narada, freedom of movement in all the three worlds. So also this Upasaka has the freedom of movement. Wherever the range of Sankalpa is, that is where the freedom of movement is. Now Vaishyakara says here, at, so yava sankalpa chyashude vishaya sankocham dashayade. So what will be the range of Sankalpa? Vaishyakara says, atmana sankalpasya yatha kamacharo bhavati. So sankalpa gochara. So yavat sankalpasya gatam, yavat atmana sankalpasya gatam. Although Shruti says sankalpa, Vaishyakara says that whatever sankalpa should be restricted to atmana sankalpa, only his own will, what will be the range of his will. So that is where he gets the freedom of movement and not sankalpa in general. Nadu sarvesham sankalpasyeve. Because Upanishad says sankalpa, that means it can appear sankalpa will in general. That means everybody wills. Then that would cover so much. Says no. He has a freedom of movement in the range where his own sankalpa has, you know, the movement. Sri sankalpasya yavat gochara tatrasya kamacharo bhavati sambandha. So whatever be the range of his own sankalpa, he gets the freedom of movement in that range. Nirankusha sankalpa shabde kahani. So why do you restrict the word sankalpa to mean atmana sankalpa, meaning his own will only? Why not will in general? So what is to be lost? Kahani? What's the problem? So Vaishyakara says, Uttarafala virodhat. Because then there will be contradiction with the phala, the result that is stated of subsequent upasanas. So the discussion doesn't stop here. Chittam vava sankalpat bhuya. This will go on and on. And as he meditates upon chitta, he gains the freedom of movement in the range of chitta. Then it will be further said, you know, so what is it? Dhyanam vava chitta bhuya. He meditates upon dhyanam and get the freedom of movement where there is a range of dhyana. Meaning that as he proceeds further and meditates upon subtler and subtler aspects, he gets further and further freedom. But if he gets right away the freedom of movement wherever sankalpa is, then it includes everybody's sankalpa. If then he gets freedom of movement everywhere, then no point in further meditation at all. Because the result that is promised for further meditation will automatically include it. If your sankalpa means anybody's sankalpa or Ishvara's sankalpa, that includes everything. Sri Ranagari, yadi sankalpa matrasya gochare sankalpa upasakasya kamacharo bhavati tarhi sarva sankalpasya vichitrataya sarva gocharatva sambhavat yavat chittasya gatam ityadina vakshamanam phalam viruddheta. संकल्पमात्रस्य गोचरे संकल्प उपासस्य कामचार भवति. इफ दिस संकल्प उपासक द मेडिटेट अपॉन संकल्प गेन्स द फ्रीडम ऑफ मूवमेंट वेर द रेंज ऑफ संकल्प इन जनरल देन सर्व संकल्पस्य देन एवरीबडी डज संकल्प सर्व संकल्पस्य विचित्रतया एवरीबडी डज डिफरेंट संकल्प सो द आउटकम विल बी डिफरेंट सर्व गोचरत्व संभवात. Therefore, all sankalpas will include everything. Chittasya gatam yavach. Then, subsequently, chittam vava sankalpat bhuyah, it will be said. Then, meditate upon the chittam as Brahma gains again freedom of movement where there is range of chitta. But that's already included here. Ityadina vakshamana phalam virudhyeta. Then, that phalam will have no meaning because it's already included. नहीं संकल्प उपासना देव सर्वस्मिन् फले सिद्धे. व्हेन ऑल द फल इज अटेन्ड बाय मेडिटेशन ऑन संकल्प चित्तादि उपासनम तत्फलम वा पृथक कथयितुम् उचितम. व्हाट्स द पॉइंट इन सेइंग दैट मेडिटेट अपॉन चित्त एंड ध्यान एटसेट्रा. अतः यावत् संकल्पस्य इत्यादि श्रुतेः उक्तः संकोचः युक्तः. देयरफॉर द संकोच द रिस्ट्रिक्शन that Bhashyakara said that he has a freedom of movement in the range of his own sankalpa and not in sankalpa in general is quite proper. The other Tikakara says also, first of all, in line 35, page 308, Uttarayati, Vakshamana, Bhoya Bhoya, Vastu Upasana, it must be Dirya, Vastu Upasanasya, Uttarottarani Phalam Vaktavyam. So subsequently, greater and greater entities will be stated and the result also will be greater and greater. Nachid vaktam shakyate, but that will not be greater. Sankala matra gahane sarvasya ishvara sankalpa gocharatvena tato adhikasya abhavat. Sankala matra also includes ishvara sankalpa and that includes everything. There is nothing greater than the range of ishvara sankalpa. ततः अधिकस्य उभावात् उत्तर उपासनं न स्यात्. ही ऑलरेडी हैज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ व्हाट इज टू बी अटेन्ड बाय द हाईएस्ट एंटिटी. देन देयर इज नो पॉइंट इन सेइंग दैट नो मेडिटेट अपॉन चित्तम एंड मेडिटेट अपॉन ध्यान. व्हाई शुड आई मेडिटेट व्हेन आई ऑलरेडी हैव व्हाट चित्तम एंड ध्यान हैज टू प्रोड्यूस. सो संकल्प मात्र ग्रहणे तु तत् अगोचरस्य अधिकस्य उत्तरफलत्वं भवति. If the restriction is one's own sankalpa, then still there is a vaster region that remains beyond that, and therefore the greater result can be there. Iti uttarasya phalam na viruddhyate, then there is no contradiction between what is stated here and what is stated later. But now the Tikakara adds on the page 309. इदंतु संभवाद अगेन कम्स बैक टू हिज ओन ओपिनियन. इदंतु संभवादुक्तम. सो अर्लियर आल्सो द टीकाकार सेड दैट इवन दो इज उपास्वयते इन एवरी अल्टरनेट द टीचर सेज मे यू मेडिटेट अपॉन दैट मेडिटेशन इज ओनली फॉर द मंद बुद्धि. अदरवाइज दिस पैसेजेस आर ऑल इंटरप्रिटेड फॉर ज्ञान. अदरवाइज So there is a problem, a debate here. But this seventh chapter is about upasana or about Brahma Vidya. So upasana is only for manda buddhi and this is only for knowledge or Brahma Vidya, you know. Namadibhya prasak bhutam pratyagatmana bhutam namadi upanyasa. That nama, mantra, and then karma, and then manas, then sankalpa, vaak, and manas, and sankalpa, and chittam, all of these is stated for what? Nama adibhya prasak bhutam pratyagatmanam bodhayatum. That he says Narada, pratyagatma is different from them. So then Narada realizes, Sankalpa is pratyagatma. Then it's true. Chittam vava sankalpa bhuya. In Narada, chittam is greater than sankalpa. So he gives up the identification with sankalpa and establishes identification with chittam. Then dhyana. So therefore, namadibhya prasabhudam pratyagatmanam bodhaitum. The pratyagatma is different from all these beginning from nama. Namad upanyasa. That's the purpose of this. Upasana vidanandu mandanam chittikagriyaya ashritya vidhananyayana. Upasana vidhan is for chitta ikagriyaya. The chitta ikagriyaya also gets accomplished for the one who needs that. But otherwise, for the uttamadhikari, it's only atma anatma viveka is what is being stated here. So therefore, continuing that line of thinking, idantu sambhavaduktam. Then, the word sankalpa should be restricted to mean only atmana sankalpa, one's own will, so that it does not interfere with what is stated later on. Sambhavaduktam, it only applies to a person who needs to meditate. Vastu dastu, or that one person meditates upon everything one by one. So taking for granted that one person will meditate upon nama and vak and manaha and chitta and sankalpa, etc., etc. So imagining that all of these people meditate. Vastu dastu sarvesham upasananam ekartrudhyam. But it is not that when it says, so sankalpam upasvayate, chittam upasvayate, it is not meant that this is being told to one person. Sarvesham upasananam ekakartrutva niyam ahavena. All the upasanas are not enjoined necessarily for one person. Ekavida phalasadhaneshu api na upayeshu pravritti virodha. Never. Even though all the upasanas give us only one phala, since the upasakas are different, therefore, the one phala can be there because the upasakas are different, can be different. Assuming that all this is stated of one upasaka, then only there is a virodha with what follows. If it is meant for an individual upasaka, then what the sankalpa fellow gets also is according to chittam and dhyanam, etc. So, na pravritti virodha. Therefore, there is no problem with the other upasanas if they are performed by other people. Sarvebhya, kamebhya, shuta, jyotishtoma, darshanadishu iva, tattat aruchya, tasya tasya, pravritti, upapatte. Look in the karma kanda, so many rituals are prescribed. Jyotishtoma, darshapurnamasa, so many rituals are prescribed. Sometimes the result is the same. If you perform Jyotishtoma, then also you get Swarga. Perform Darsha Purnamasa, then also you get Swarga. And therefore, they have different rituals which give you the same result. Then Tattat Aruchya, which one will you perform? You don't like this, you don't like that, you perform the ritual of your choice. So also you can say that there's so many upasanas are prescribed here. For the total result, you can perform whichever one you like. Tasya tasya pravritti upattehe. So one person need not do all the upasanas. You can choose your upasana. Just as in karma kanda, you choose your ritual for a given result. Adhika phala abhavepi na dosha. So that should have gone earlier actually. Ekavida phala sadhaneshu api na upayeshu adhika phala abhavepi na dosha. Okay. Sadhaneshu api adhika phala abhavepi, even though adhika phala is not there, na dosha. Anyatha yavannam nogatam tatrasya kamachara bhavad ityadishu nama agocharasya bhavad. Earlier said, nama upasva. Yavan nam nogatam, what will be the range of nama? Tatrasya kama chara bhavati. In that range, this upasa gets the freedom of movement. Itya nama agocharasya bhavayama. There is nothing which is not covered by nama. Nama covers everything. Therefore, tat adhika phala bhavayana tato bhuyasa upasana nasya. So then, in nama upasana itself, you get everything. There is nothing great more than that. So the subsequent upasanas will have no meaning at all. If you expect that adhika phala is there, phala is there, you choose your upasana, that's what this tikakara says. So, uttara phala virodhat, ukta phala yadi kvachit paatha, ukta phala virodhat. Tatra sankalva gochara madhya eva dhruvatvad visheshana visheshya lokanabhi antarbhavena prithak tadrana virodhat ityartha. So then already you say, you know, what did you say? Kluptame lokan abhisiddhyati. So already the result of the meditation of Sankalpa is stated that he attains the worlds that are immutable, that are well established, that are free from sorrow. So Sankalpa gochara madhya eva dhruvatvad visheshana visheshya lokana abhi antarbhavena. Therefore, all of these lokas are already included in there. Prusaktat grahana virodhat, therefore, to say that he attains the freedom of movement, because already stated he attains all these worlds. So, ukta phala virodhat. So, skruptan loka, whatever sankalpa he has done, those lokas he attains. If he attains sankalpa, loka of anybody's sankalpa, then it will only contradict what is stated here. That in these worlds that are only willed by him. So ukta phala virodhat also it can be stated. Alright. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamada. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Balarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmeri Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namah. Om Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo